Okay, can we get the Rhythm Dukettes here now?
Y'all know it. Yeah. show you just how I feel. Cause love is real, not fade away. Love is real, not fade away. And love is love, not fade away. And love is real, not fade away.
Not fade away!
Grateful Dead get their name. And I got a phone call from a film company that was making a film about the Grateful Dead. And they said we need a definitive statement about where the phrase Grateful Dead comes from. And it turns out it comes from folk tales and fairy tales. And stories of the Grateful Dead actually have been all around the world in all different cultures. So that it's almost like an archetypal idea, image. And typically, the story is about the youngest son or the third son. It could be the third daughter. It's the same thing. It's the youngest part of the psyche. And so the youngest son leaves the kingdom or leaves the hut of his poor father. Whatever it is, there's all kinds of versions. And on the road, he encounters a situation where there's someone has died, and the priest or the town or the authorities are unwilling to bury the person. They won't bury him because he's poor and can't pay for it. They won't bury him because he's different from them and they're taking advantage of their authority for some reason they won't bury the person who has died. And it turns out that there's something sacred about honoring the dead, about burying the dead, about respecting the dead. And so they were violating a basic tenet of humanity. And here came the youngest son. And he came upon the scene and he said, why won't you bury him? And they said, well, no one, he can't pay for it, no one can pay for it, and so he's going to lay there and rot. And the youngest son said, I'll pay for it. How much? And they said the amount, and it was the equal amount to all the money he had in the world. And so he paid for the burial of the person who otherwise wasn't going to be buried. And then he went on his path, or on his road. And as he was going down the road, someone appeared to him and began to speak to him and said, where are you going? He said, I don't really know. I'm just out in the world wandering around. And then the person who appeared said, well, I have some guidance for you. There's a forest that you need to go to because it's a very special place. And so this person that appeared begins to guide and protect him. And of course, it's the Grateful Dead. It's the person who he had paid to bury who appears back on the road of his life as the Grateful Dead person. It's pretty cool, huh? So I told this story in front of the cameras with the Golden Gate Bridge behind me and so on. But I didn't know at the time that Jerry Garcia had actually found the story. And he knew where it came from. That's where he got the idea from. So anyway, the story can get very complicated, but here's the short version, because this is clearly a long night. But it's great to know that we're in the hands, we're in the arms, we're in the spirit of the Grateful Dead. And so, the person who had been the corpse that was now the Grateful Dead takes the youngest son into this forest on the side of a mountain. And it's beautiful and it's stunning. And when they enter, everything goes quiet. And somehow the youngest son is told that you cannot speak or say a word while you're here. But you know how youngest sons are. You know how youngest daughters are. They can't help but say what they feel. And so he speaks and he violates the rule and he's punished. And the way he's punished is he becomes both dumb, deaf, and blind. And then the Grateful Dead appears again and takes those problems away from him and returns his sight and his voice and returns him to the world of the living in a way. And then the Grateful Dead, the person who had been unburied but now was grateful and dead but kind of alive like the living dead, then the Grateful Dead gives him a drink of something that stimulates some part of him that had not yet awakened. I don't know if that's IPA or whiskey or the elixir or soma. You figure it out. And then he picks up an instrument and he begins to play music and he begins to heal the youngest son in this forest that no one knows about. And so then the youngest son joins the people that live there in that forest and they're all a little bit odd. And they like to sing and they like to dance. And he begins to join and dance with the women and sing with the people. And he has the greatest time of his life. And everything inside him opens up. And he begins to see not just the simple world, but also the other world. And he becomes part of that. And he stays there for a while. And then every once in a while, you have to go back to the regular world. That'll happen at the end of this night also. You have to go back to the regular world. But anytime he wanted to go back to that other world where the healing is, where the elixir is, where the music is, where the imagination is, all he had to do was say, give me some inspiration. Give me the breath of inspiration. That's all I need. That's all I want. Give me the inspiration.
Token rhyme suggesting a rhythm that will not forsake me till my tale is told and done. While the firelights are low, strange shadows of flames will grow till things will.
looks of him who's been through many fights, lost and loved. Show.
the mother of twins. Two times over and the rest was sin. Raising boys on the outer man. Yeah, the liquor the other ones had.
Out the
just another of pretty things. Maybe the pain of a thing.
told I feel a roving sign. I was born to be a bachelor. So now I'm trying to catch you. Well, can't talk to you without talking to me.
Just to cool him down. Yeah. This is Down Home Grateful Dead Blues. They didn't write very many blues songs, but this is sure one of them. to give. I guess that was it.
And thanks for coming out, and thanks for all the musicians who came up, and thanks for your patience between acts and stuff. But we're getting kicked out. We're already an hour over our time. We could probably go 2 hours over our time. We have to go. So anyway, thanks for coming out. See you next year.
Scott, let's give it up for Scott Jerky. We love you, Scott. Scott made this all happen, man. Scott.
Thank you, guys. I really appreciate it. Really. See you next year.
Thanks, Nate.
Nate, I sent earlier. He did an amazing job. From what I hear, it sounded really good.
Michael, you rock, brother.
Thanks,
Michael. You like monkey.